substances which allows electric current to pass through it is called conductors. And the substances which do not allow electric current to pass through it is called insulators. The question for this discussion is, do liquids conduct electricity? Let's try to find out answer in this video. In class 6, you have learned to create a tester with the help of cell, 4 wires and a bulb. Create a similar tester, but instead of using a cell, this time use a battery. With the tester, perform the activity given in the screen. Let's perform another activity using the tester. Take a plastic or a rubber container. Add 1 teaspoon of lemon juice or vinegar. Dip the two free ends of tester into the liquid such that the two free ends are about 1 cm distance from each other. Does the bulb glows? What does this mean? Is the liquid good conductor or a bad conductor? Observation: bulb glows as soon as the two ends are dipped in the liquid. This means that there is electrical conductivity through the liquid, which suggests that liquid is a good conductor. This suggests that liquid must be completing the circuit of the tester, due to which current must be flowing through the liquid, making the liquid a good conductor. The bulb glows as the current causes heating of filament present inside the bulb. If there is weak current, then the bulb may not glow. In such case, we use LED bulb instead of electric bulb. The LED bulb are available in variety of colors. These are capable of detecting very weak currents. The longer lead is always connected to the positive terminal of a battery, and the shorter lead is connected to the negative terminal. There is another way of making a tester. Whenever a magnetic needle comes closer to a current carrying wire, it undergoes deflection. Can we use this principle to make a tester? Yes, we can. Here is activity showing how we can do it. Focus on distilled water and tap water. Tap water is good conductor, but distilled water is poor conductor. Didn't you find it interesting? Actually, reason lies in the fact that tap water contains different salts dissolved in it, and salt solutions conduct electricity. Salts are absent in distilled water, and therefore, distilled water won't conduct. To summarize discussion, dear students, most liquids which conduct electricity are solutions of acids, bases, or salts. I hope you have understood this topic well.